TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Tuesday, the 31st of December. Cold wave conditions hit normal life in parts of northern India. MQM Pakistan rejects Bilawal Bhutto's offer to topple government. And Taliban refutes reports of ceasefire plans in Afghanistan. Now for all the details, cold wave conditions continue to affect normal life in parts of northern India on Tuesday. People who stepped out for daily activities were seen wrapped in several layers of clothing and huddled around bonfires to fight the chill.
Teeth-chattering cold wave conditions continued in parts of northern India on Tuesday. A thick blanket of fog engulfed northern Jammu city on Tuesday morning as people who stepped out for their daily activities were seen wrapped in several layers of clothing to protect themselves. The temperature dropped to 8 degrees Celsius in Indian capital New Delhi, while in Jammu it was 11 degrees Celsius at 12 p.m. on Tuesday.
सर्दी देखिए ये जो है सर्दी बहुत ज्यादा सर्दी है लोगों का घर से बाहर निकलना मुश्किल हो रहा है फ्रॉम लास्ट टू डेज इट वाज एक्सट्रीमली कोल्ड हियर विद दिस ड्यू द पीपल आर नॉट द रोड्स आर नॉट विजिबल क्लियरली एंड द पीपल कम आउट ऑफ देयर होम्स टू बाय द जैकेट्स फॉर देयर सेल्फ इट्स एक्सट्रीमली कोल्ड इट इज अनबियरेबल कोल्ड
सिमिलर सीन्स वर विटनेस्ड इन लुधियाना सिटी ऑफ नॉर्दर्न पंजाब प्रोविंस एज पीपल वोर मल्टीपल लेयर्स ऑफ क्लोथिंग एंड सम गैदर्ड अराउंड बॉनफायर्स to fight the chill. Snowfall in Jammu and Kashmir region and hill province of Himachal Pradesh has a direct impact in northern provinces of Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh and capital New Delhi.
ठंड पड़ रही है सर्दी में मर रहे हैं लोग और काम धंधा लग नहीं रहा हाथ पैर सेक रहे
हैं. Amid the prevailing foggy weather conditions in the region, the border security force has intensified its patrolling along the India-Pakistan border in Punjab. Every year from mid-December to February, dense fog reduces visibility at the border to almost zero, especially in the morning and evening hours, making it a big challenge for the force to detect misadventures of the anti-national elements across the border.
Outgoing Indian Army Chief General Bipin Rawat, who has been appointed as India's first Chief of Defence Staff, said he will now plan a new strategy for his fresh role. Rawat received his farewell guard of honour on Tuesday and conveyed best wishes to General Manoj Mukund Narwane, who assumed office as the 28th Army Chief.
Indian government on Monday appointed Indian Army Chief General Bipin Rawat as the first Chief of Defence Staff or CDS with a mandate to bring in convergence in functioning of the Army, the Navy and the Indian Air Force. General Rawat received his farewell guard of honour as the Army Chief on Tuesday in capital New Delhi after completing his three-year tenure. In his new role as the CDS, General Rawat will assume a key role where he will be the single point of contact for the government. General Rawat said the Indian Army is better equipped to take on challenges from enemies and that he will now plan a new strategy for his fresh role.
Today, as I demit the office of the Chief of Army Staff of the Indian Army, I wish to convey my gratitude and compliments to the soldiers, the rank and file of our Indian Army, who have stood steadfast under challenging circumstances.
Later, General Manoj Mukund Narwane took charge as the 28th Chief of Army Staff on Tuesday. General Rawat handed over the baton of the Chairman of Chiefs of Staff Committee to his successor. General Narwane assumes the new role months after he was appointed as Vice Chief of the Army in September. He was earlier heading the Eastern Command of the Army, which takes care of India's nearly 4,000-kilometer border with China.
Moving on, the Mutahida Qawmi Movement, Pakistan, has declined the offer of Pakistan People's Party chairperson Bilawal Bhutto Zardari to quit alliance with the ruling PTI government in exchange for ministries in the Sindh government. The party said although it was not satisfied with the performance of Prime Minister Imran Khan-led government, but it will not quit the alliance at the whim of someone.
Hours after Pakistan People's Party chairperson Bilawal Bhutto Zardari offered ministries in exchange for breaking alliance with Prime Minister Imran Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf or PTI government, the Mutahida Qawmi Movement Pakistan or MQMP declined the offer. Local media reports said the MQMP in a statement said that the party cares about the welfare of the people instead of seats, and although they were not satisfied with the performance of the federal government, it will not quit the alliance at the whim of someone. Speaking at an event in Karachi on Monday, Bilawal had said, "Today or tomorrow, all the allies of the PTI will have to take the decision to save the people of Pakistan who are suffering due to the wrong policies of the PTI government." Imran Khan-led government has 156 PTI lawmakers in the 342-member National Assembly. The government has the support of 28 other lawmakers, including 7 from the MQMP. The combined opposition has 158 members in the lower house of the parliament and has been trying to oust the government, alleging the PTI came to power with the backing of the powerful military.
In news from Afghanistan, at a time when hopes for peace in Afghanistan were high again, Taliban has rejected the reports of a possible ceasefire. The group in a statement said discussions are still underway about a reduction of violence in the country, but there are no plans of a ceasefire.
Spokesperson of the Taliban in Afghanistan, Jabiullah Mujahid, has rejected media reports claiming the ruling council of the group had agreed to a temporary ceasefire. Mujahid, in a statement on Monday, said that discussions are still underway about a reduction of violence and lessened operations, but there are no ceasefire plans. The statement from the militant group comes as Afghan troops backed by foreign forces brace for another bloody winter amid renewed US-Taliban peace talks. Washington had paused the talks for a while in the wake of a suicide attack carried out by the group near a U.S. airbase in Afghanistan. The two sides had earlier reached an agreement in principle in September, but the negotiations were called off over repeated attacks by the group.
And news from Nepal, elephants with mural paintings over their bodies in Nepal took part in an unusual beauty pageant recently, which aimed to bring humans closer to them, encourage wildlife protection and conservation, and promote tourism in the region.
Elephants with mural paintings over their bodies participated in an unusual elephant's beauty pageant in a tourism hub in southwest Nepal's Chitwan district on Sunday. This year's celebrations mark the 16th edition of the annual Chitwan Elephant Festival, in which the beauty pageant enthralled a large number of visitors from across the country. The elephants were judged on the basis of overall cleanliness of both body and nails, their walking style and discipline for obeying the instructions given by the mahouts. The elephant who wins the show gets a treat of delicious food, whereas the owner of the elephant is awarded a cash prize. Apart from a great opportunity to interact and generate awareness about the elephants, the festival also encourages wildlife protection and conservation and promotes tourism in the region.
Cricket bats from India's Jammu and Kashmir are known worldwide for fine quality willow used to manufacture them. The cricket bat industry continues to generate employment for scores of people in the valley, as on an average 5 to 8 persons are employed in several bat manufacturing units operating across the region.
The cricket bat industry in India's Jammu and Kashmir continues to generate employment for hundreds of people in the valley. Kashmir willow is renowned worldwide and is second only to the famous English Willow for manufacturing of fine quality cricket bat. Sangam village in Anantnag district is among the 7 villages in south of Kashmir where on an average 5 to 8 persons are employed in several bat manufacturing units, hence providing them bread and butter. With a huge demand for bats and other sporting gear in the cricket mad nation, the employees can be seen busy in cutting and filling the edges of countless bats to a smooth finish.
Randai ka kaam hota hai, aare ka kaam hota hai, banwai ka kaam hota hai, regmar ka kaam hota hai, handle thokne ka kaam hota hai, press ka kaam hota hai, sir isme bahut mehnat hai.
और जहाँ तक हमारे एरिया की कश्मीर की बात की जाए, यहाँ से जो जनरेट हुआ है क्रिकेट बैट, दैट इज संगम एरिया. संगम एरिया में यहाँ पर यूनिट होल्डर्स की अगर हम बात करेंगे, देर आर नियर अबाउट 300 to 400 यूनिट होल्डर्स इन द कश्मीर वैली एंड नियर अबाउट 5 to 8 मेंबर्स आर वर्किंग इन ईच यूनिट.
कश्मीरी बैट्स आर फेमस ऑल ओवर द कंट्री and many national and international cricket players use these bats. Those associated with the manufacturing of sports equipment express, if the government takes more steps, the cricket bat industry in Kashmir Valley is a lucrative venture and can absorb more people.
Women in southern India took part in a night walk recently as they attempted to reclaim the streets at night. The initiative was aimed to create awareness and instill confidence among women for them to feel safe to come out in the dark.
Women from different fields of life took part in a walk in Thiruvananthapuram city of India's southern Kerala province as they attempted to reclaim the streets at night recently. The night walk organized by Kerala government saw women along with their children take part as they aim to create awareness and instill confidence in women and feel safe to come out in the dark. The event was organized on the death anniversary of a young physiotherapist who was raped in December 2012 in national capital New Delhi. The victim died due to the physical injuries inflicted upon her.
I think it's really an interesting initiative because this is something that is never talked about how women are so insecure, after a certain time. And that the darkness becomes the way to also restrict women from doing anything. So the fact that we can actually step out and say, look, this darkness is ours also, and we don't have to be nervous, I think it's a very good way of bringing across a very strong message.
Most of the women are scared to get out in the night. Especially when we hear a lot of scary news about women being raped and women being attacked in different parts of the country, it's the need of the hour to ensure confidence, to instill confidence in women to get out in the night.
India strengthened its laws on sexual violence against women after the 2012 Delhi gang rape that led to an outpouring of anger. However, the country recorded more than 32,500 cases of rape in 2017, about 90 a day, according to the most recent government data.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. Cold wave conditions hit normal life in parts of northern India. MQM Pakistan rejects Bilawal Bhutto's offer to topple government. And Taliban refutes reports of ceasefire plans in Afghanistan. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter at SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.